Aloha, I am Queenittra Toilolo. I'm 34 years old. I'm 460 pounds. I'm a full-time student. And this is my application video for The Biggest Loser, Season 10. I was born in Honolulu, Hawaii, to my birth parents, who in turn gave me up for adoption to a family member and her husband. I grew up in a little town called Palmdale, California. I came from both an emotional and physical abusive home. I had to grow up really fast at an early age, and without realizing it, I began my bad emotional eating habits. Growing up, I was always the biggest or tallest girl in my class. People would always tell me, "It's okay that you're big. It's natural. It's in your culture." Or, "You're not fat. You're just big boned." So I grew up thinking it's okay to be big. I never saw my weight as a disadvantage. And throughout all the turmoil in my life, the one thing I was always proud of was being me. Because in the end, that's all I can be, is me. A big, funny girl whom everyone wants to be around. In my younger years, while being a big girl, I still managed to be somewhat active. I'd go out with my friends all the time, participate in sports, and go dancing. I came to Hawaii in 2001 to meet my biological family and decided to stay. My eating habits became worse. See, here in Hawaii, food plays a big part in every event. Back home in California, the parties I attended, there were mostly chips and dip and the occasional pizza. Parties there are all about the alcohol and music. Here, it's all about what's being served at the party. The occasion doesn't matter. It could be a meeting, a baby shower, even a funeral. There's always going to be a lot of food. Add to that the wonderful spirit of aloha, and it's a heart attack waiting to happen. A perfect stranger here will make sure you have a plate to eat now and a plate to take home whenever you're at a gathering. I continue to be active and sociable. On February 19, 2007, my partner and I were given the opportunity to adopt a beautiful baby boy, and we jumped at that chance. We had him from the time he came home from the hospital until he was nearly 18 months. Paperwork wasn't complete, and his birth mother decided she wanted to be a mother again and took him back. I was devastated. This beautiful, bright baby boy had been my life and meant the world to me. He was my everything, and I put his needs before my wants. It was all about him, because if he was happy, then my world seemed bright and all was well, balanced, and at peace. The day he was taken was the day I lost the last piece of dignity within myself. I could care less what people said or did. I could care less about myself and the way I looked. I ate away the pain, slept the days away, went through the motions when it came to work. No more, no less. I didn't want to do anything, go anywhere, see anyone. I have since then been blessed with a beautiful goddaughter named Jordan. I try hard not to get attached to her, but looking at her smile, it's hard not to. She has given me the hunger to want to do better and has given me hope that one day I will be a parent again. I went back to school as a full-time student, majoring in social work. But as I try to do better for myself, I find myself having a hard time. Like any campus, this campus is huge, and with two stories. I attend classes every day, and every day I have a class upstairs and one downstairs. Every day is a challenge for me. From the minute I get out of the car until I get to my class, I'll need at least 3 or 4 breaks, or else I'll be dripping in sweat. Sometimes it looks like I just got out of the shower, and it's so embarrassing. I lose my breath very easily. The worst part for me is I hate the first day of classes. I never know if there's gonna be a seat for me or not. The regular desks never fit me, so I'm given a big table and a chair. I almost always feel like an outcast because the whole class will be sitting together and I'm off to the side. I'm tired of always feeling tired. I don't want to be an outcast no more. I want to be a part of everything. I have so much I want to do. I have a desire to help young people from low-income families to go to college, and also want to help children who come from a background of child abuse because I know what it's like to be in their shoes. And most importantly, I want to start a family of my own and be able to be healthy enough to raise them and watch them grow into families of their own. I want to be able to take my goddaughter to Disneyland and ride the rides with her. I want my life back. That's why I want to be the biggest loser.